name is Mirza Hasan Askari. Very few people know this fact. I'm 30. I have a wife and a two-year-old baby. I did my undergraduate degree in Canada. I was there for 4 years. I studied political science. मेरा पूरा focus पाकिस्तान की regional stability पे था. ये सब करके मैं वापस पाकिस्तान आया, अपना CSS का इम्तिहान दिया, वो लड़क दिया और फिर मैंने 3 साल अमन फाउंडेशन में काम किया था, फोकसिंग ऑन जस्ट डेवलपमेंट पाकिस्तान में. आई थिंक बड़ी ज़रूरी चीज़ है, खासतौर पर इतना फ्लाइट ऑफ कैपिटल और लेबर भी होता है, क्या कुछ बंदा कोशिश तो करे अपने मुल्क की बेहतरी के लिए. सो आई डिड दैट फॉर 3 ईयर्स एंड देन आई टुक ओवर माई मदर्स बिजनेस, दिस वन कंपनी उनके नाम पर, शमाज बेकरी, एंड शी इस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1993. तो ये सब कर करा के अब मैं एसेंशली बावर्ची हूँ एंड आई बेक एंड कुक फॉर अ लिविंग एंड yeah, I mean, we do that. We work with many restaurants in Karachi, and actually all over Pakistan now, providing them their dessert and confectionery requirements. So that's what I do. वहाँ पे alternatively पे जो दो तीन शौक हैं, by and large जो मुझे चीजें शौक करने का, एक तो महंगी है unfortunately, और दूसरा ये है कि उसमें थोड़ा एक risk level होता है which I enjoy. Hence diving is something that I decided to get into.
Yeah, that's that would be my second question. Ke, what's your journey in scuba diving? I mean,
so it's again actually it's the reason why my mother has been diving Pakistan with agreement for I'd say about 15 maybe 18 years she's been diving. She's an advanced diver.
Wow.
I don't think there were many women at that time who had reached that license level at least. So wo karti thi kafi British, she still does it. She enjoys it a lot. And something I saw growing up, but I never got into. तो थोड़ी बहुत हमने जो हल्की फुल्की ट्रैवल की थी such as Thailand and a couple of other places, वहाँ पर मैंने शो किया, एक दो DSDs की. I decided I really enjoyed it. And when I came back to Pakistan after college, I figured यार इसको किसी तरीके से pursue करना है, at least at a licensed level. तो then I became licensed. I've been licensed now for कितना टाइम हुआ भाई, आपने तो लाइसेंस किया मुझे, कितना टाइम हुआ?
तीसरा साल
शुरू होने वाला है. थर्ड ईयर. या सो व्हाट अ व्हाइल नाउ आई हैव बीन लाइसेंस्ड.
वेरी नाइस. सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान हैव यू बीन टू एनी डाइविंग ट्रिप्स इंटरनेशनली?
जी बिल्कुल, मैंने जो फर्स्ट DSD किया था दैट वाज इन थाईलैंड. अगेन माय मदर वाज डाइविंग, उनकी गुई उस दिन काफी डाइव्स थी, डीप डाइव्स भी थी, और मैं स्नॉर्कलिंग करने निकला था उनके साथ. एंड वहीं पे एक्चुअली उनकी जो डाइव इंस्ट्रक्टर है she convinced me also ke aap dive kare, and so I did my first DSD there. I enjoyed it a lot. Swimming is something I've done my entire life competitively also, alag ab lagta nahi hai but karta tha main sindh ke liye,
right?
And so I did one DSD there. I really enjoyed it. The unfortunate thing was ke the next time I did a dive was in the Maldives many years later.
Wow.
Bilkul, it should be a dream destination. Yeah. A very expensive dream destination. So that's once, hopefully not once in a lifetime. My second one was there, was again a DSD. And the reason for that was I was foolish enough that I should have just at that time in Thailand on my first dive, just done the license. And all of this would have cost me a lot less to learn and figure out.
Exactly.
So I did my dive in Thailand actually on my honeymoon with my wife, who also did her DSD for the second time. She's done 2 DSDs as well. And so that was my second time in Thailand. First one was in Thailand, which was quite nice. The second was in the Maldives, and the third was after I was licensed. It was earlier this year, I think, in Bali, Indonesia.
So that was a certified dive.
Yes.
Not a DSD.
No, not DSD. Finally, I was a certified diver.
So what about Pakistan? I mean, you talked about Maldives.
Yeah. So I think every country I've dived in has been unique in some way. Thailand. Aside from the fact that diving is great in Thailand, there's a good amount of marine life. It's also affordable, which was nice. The Maldives was very unaffordable,
but very expensive.
Yeah. That said, you get what you pay for with the water. It's cleaner than most drinking water, just that clear, which was very nice.
Yeah.
And my third dive was in Bali, which was nice, and that was an interesting experience because that was my first dive with my license and outside of my comfort zone, not with the instructor I always dive with, i.e. Mustafa bhai and a few others. So that was my first sort of solo dive alone as a licensed diver. And that was also a very interesting experience. Considerable amount to see. Shallow dive, I think 12 meters maybe. So those are all great. Majority of my diving has been now in Pakistan. Most of which has been done at Charna Island. Which is kind of nice. There's always something new to see. Charna is quite large, which is something people don't realize. I think, you know, you tell them I'm diving at Charna, they ask you, how do you dive at this place? And I have twofold answer to that. One is that Charna has many sites to dive on.
Exactly.
Some I haven't even seen yet, even though I've done a fair few dives now. And the other one is, it's marine life. Yeah? I mean, one day you might see many things, one day you won't. It's the same if you went to the Serengeti and watched the animal migration. You don't see it every day. Well, some days you'll see certain things, some days you'll see certain things. Pakistan is quite interesting. Again, it's more affordable than a lot of other places to dive, so that's a big plus. Things are slightly cheaper here. The water you can choose even at Charna, at what depth you want to dive. You can go anywhere from fairly shallow water to fairly deep water. And I think that's a good option to have. You know, travel 15 minutes from where you are by boat and be able to do a deep dive or whatever else. So I think it offers a little bit for everyone. Pakistan waters, I'd say in my limited experience, can be a bit difficult to dive in because it's just a big open sea. But I think if you can master that, you can dive anywhere in the world.
Exactly.
Which is nice. And you know, it's really nice here sometimes also, especially come December, Jan, Feb, water with Charna is like a lake. And quite enjoyable. And good clarity also.
So apart from Charna, any specific dive spots?
So I've done a couple other ones, sort of exploratory dives. I did a few from French Beach, which was a cool thing. I've been going to the beach since I was very young, and I always thought it'd be interesting to see the same beach which I've been seeing for decades, except from underwater. Also, I'm extremely scared of sharks. So every time I've been swimming at French Beach for 20 years, all I've been thinking about is jaws.
I went exploring. That's your main issue, sharks.
So I went exploring first hand to see if it actually exists there or not, and to put that to a rest once and for all.
I still remember, sorry to cut you through, I still remember last season, we were on the boat heading towards Charna and we saw a whale's fin.
Yes, that's a very good point actually. Again, like I was saying, at Charna, sometimes you get to see a very small fish your entire dive.
Yeah.
And sometimes you see the fin of what I imagine was a fairly large whale. And I remember being the first one who saw that fin. And I tried communicating it, but mere literally halak mein atak gaya tha. So, finally when I managed to communicate that I've seen something outside the water,
right.
I remember it being a few feet long, and unlike me, everyone else was getting excited about jumping into the water to see it. I decided against that, and luckily the whale then turned over on its side, which was really cool to see.
Yeah.
So you know, I think pictorial.
I think everyone on the boat saw that thing.
Yes, everyone saw it, which was cool. And then luckily for me, it dived and went away, and then 20 minutes later, we were asked to jump into the water at Charna to start the dive. And I sent less experienced divers than me first, just to ensure that, you know, if someone will eat someone, then the first one will eat, not the third one will eat. So, so back to the French Beach dive I did. It was quite enjoyable. It was a shore dive, which poses its own challenges anywhere in the world, but a lot of fun. And it was just an interesting experience to dive somewhere where, you know, I swam for so many years and see what it's like underneath. So that is quite fun also.
So do you have any future plans in terms of certification you want to
Yes, dive? So currently I'm an open water diver, which is great. But diving is like one of those things that there's very few people dive who then don't end up doing it religiously. Mm-hmm. And everyone sort of just wants to be able to do a little bit more. And so currently I think I'd be happy with the master scuba diver.
Wow.
At least.
Wow, nice.
It's little bit ego, little bit ability to dive better. You know, and just, I think just get better at it generally. And I think scuba diving is one of those things that the better you get at, the more you enjoy. Because you're less, you know, stressed about equipment and buoyancy and things like that. And you can enjoy it a lot more if, you know, you get better at it.
Right.
So definitely, I think that's the trajectory, hopefully soon.
Perfect. Okay, guys, we're going on a short break. Don't go away. We'll be back after a few minutes. I just noticed that there was some issue with my voice, that the few minutes of the entire broadcast was on mute. I'm sorry about it. Okay, let me introduce myself again. My name is Mustafa Hassan, and I am a Peri IDC staff instructor in Pakistan, the only one right now. Indoscopa started in November 2009, and it's been almost 10 years. This dive center is running smoothly. We have two good news. One is basically we have been granted an approval from the High Court of Sindh, and we are very thankful to PMSA, Pakistan Maritime Security Agency, and NIMA, National Institute of Maritime Affairs, who help us to, you know, went through this entire ordeal. We have two amazing divers with us. Let me again introduce, right? One is Hassan Askari, who already talked about himself. And now we're going to talk to Mr. Aram Latif. Aram, how are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Alhamdulillah, Aram. Achha, Aram, we are seeing divers. If we ask who is Aram Latif, तो क्या क्या है कौन
इस सवाल का जवाब तो आज तक मुझे नहीं पता पर चले मैं कोशिश करता हूँ अपने पास के बारे में बता के I'm Aram Yusuf Latif, I'm 27 year old. अभी तक मेरी शादी हुई नहीं
यार ये सब अपनी उम्र क्यों बता रहे हो यार I'm getting old. नहीं that's wrong.
रिश्ता I've lived most of half my life in Pakistan and half my life in America. 2007 में मैं अमेरिका गया था हाई स्कूल पढ़ा हुआ फिर मैंने मैरीलैंड में फिर मैंने यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ साउथ कैरोलिना से ग्लोबल सप्लाई चेन ऑपरेशन मैनेजमेंट की डिग्री ली
वाओ
फिर मैं वाशिंगटन डीसी मूव हुआ वहां पे मैंने सप्लाई चेन कंसल्टिंग में दो साल काम किया अपनी बहन के साथ रहा और फिर वो इनएविटेबल अबू का फोन कॉल आ गया कि बेटा
वापस आ जाओ
पाकिस्तान आ जाओ
धरती तो मैं याद कर रही हूं
बिल्कुल ऐसे ही समझ ले तो उसके बाद जैसे अबू ने फोन किया एक दो महीने के लिए मैं यूरो ट्रिप पे गया मैंने काफी एंजॉय किया और फिर मैं कराची वापस मूव हो गया 2016 से मैं कराची में हूं उसके बाद मैंने फिर यहाँ पे अबू के साथ रियल एस्टेट डेवलपमेंट में काम करता हूँ और फिर अपने अलग से स्पोर्ट्स और फिटनेस में थोड़ा
दैट वी कैन सी दैट वी कैन सी सो व्हाट्स योर जर्नी इन स्कूबा डाइविंग यानी हाउ इट ऑल स्टार्टेड कब से स्टार्ट किया कैसे पता चला हमारे बारे में कैसे बताया
तो बेसिकली बचपन से मुझे पानी का बहुत शौक था मेरे अबू बहुत अच्छे स्विमर थे तो उन्होंने मुझे मेरी बहनों को भी पूरा वक्त स्विमिंग कराची क्लब पे हम लोग रोज स्विमिंग जाते थे तो मुझे पानी से तो हमेशा शौक था बीच जाने का हमेशा शौक था फिर एज आई ग्रो अप मुझे फिर स्कूबा डाइविंग के बारे में पता चला उसको फिर मैंने बड़ा रिसर्च किया बहुत मजा आया इत्तेफाकन मैं भी अपनी फैमिली के साथ मालदीव्स गया एक फैमिली वेकेशन पे तो उधर उन्होंने वो बनाया हुआ था एक थोड़ा स्कूबा शॉप था तो मैंने थोड़ा पुश करके मैं मेरी दो बहनें इनकी बीवी मेरी एक और बहन
तभी मालदीव
रिलेटेड है ना दोनों
तो वहां से हम लोग डीएस हमने भी डीएसडी किया मुझे तो बहुत मजा आया मैंने कहा ये मुझे करना है मेरा पैशन है बहुत मजा आया फिर कभी हुआ नहीं फिर इत्तेफाक से जब मैं कराची वापस आया तो इसको भी शौक था मुझे भी शौक था और हम रोज साथ बैठते थे तो एक दूसरे को इवेंचुअली पुश करके आपसे हम मिल गए
आप लोग केक खाएं बहुत अच्छा है हम भी खाने वाले हैं थोड़ी देर में राइट चलिए प्लीज कंटिन्यू
तो बस यही था हमने एक दूसरे को पुश किया इवेंचुअली हमें शर्मा आंटी ने आपका वो दिया तारुफ दिया उन्होंने कहा ये पाकिस्तान के नंबर वन डाइवर हैं एशिया में इनके सबसे ज्यादा सर्टिफिकेशन है सेफ्टी और एफिशिएंसी के लिहाज से आप मतलब थोड़ा भी बंदा रिसर्च करता है तो आपका ही नाम आता है तो हम आपसे मिले उस दिन के बाद से तो मतलब हम तकरीबन हर दूसरे दिन ही मिलते हैं पिछले दो साल में दो सीजन में हमने तकरीबन 40 प्लस डाइव्स किए आपके साथ और अभी आपने हमें सारा मंजन बेच दिया है दूसरों को बेचते फिरते हैं ये चीज करनी है बहुत जरूरी है आई थिंक इट्स एन एब्सोल्युटली एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ टू हैव हॉबीज एंड इंटरेस्ट अदर देन योर डेली जॉब्स बिकॉज थोड़ा रिलीज होना जरूरी है फन भी होना जरूरी है ये कंस्ट्रक्टिव फन जब होती है लाइफ में तो आई थिंक मतलब पॉजिटिविटी होती है अच्छे लोग भी कर रहे होते हैं तो बड़ा मजा आता है
तो करंटली आप किस लेवल पे हो ऑन सर्टिफिकेशन लेवल
करंटली तो मैं ओपन वाटर डाइवर हूँ इस विंटर मतलब अभी से ही समझ लें कि हमने अपनी मैंने और हसन ने अपनी एडवांस शुरू कर दी है तो जब आप हमें फाइनली लेके जाएंगे इस सीजन हम अपनी एडवांस डाइविंग की शुरुआत कर लेंगे
इंशाल्लाह जबरदस्त So basically you already talk about your first experience in scuba diving that was in Maldives something like this. Europe mein kari thi kahin diving?
Europe mein nahi ki thi, maine America mein fresh water diving ki thi.
Kaisa experience tha wo?
Acha tha, different tha, kuch aisa khas nahi tha kyunki dam mein kiya tha, magar sahi tha. It's a fun, like for me it's like playing a sport, right? Aap mujhe hazar dafa cricket khilwa lo, main 1001 dafa bhi wahi karne chale jaunga. So for me diving, putting the equipment on, you know, putting the regulator in your mouth, jumping into the water the first time each and every time is such a thrill ke matlab bottom mein bhi main ja ke kar lu, pool mein bhi main ja ke kar lu, mujhe koi itna aisa.
So what about Pakistan? I mean any just tell us in Pakistan mein kahan kahan gaye dive?
Pakistan ke lihaz se to humne, maine aur Hasan ne takriban sari dive saath hi kiye hain, to jo Hasan ne bola uska jawab mere paas bhi hai. Chadna pe humne takriban 20-25 dives ki hongi aur French beach pe humne तकरीबन 10-15 डाइविंग की होंगी. हमने एक रिचुअल बना लिया था पिछले दो सीजन से कि हर वेंसडे हम सुबह के 5 बजे उठते थे, फ्रेंच बीच जाते थे हम दोनों अकेले, वहां से हम आधा किलोमीटर 1 किलोमीटर स्विमिंग करते थे अपना इक्विपमेंट पहन के, सीधा शोर डाइव की, लेफ्ट राइट गए मछलियों के साथ इंजॉय किया. फिर
ये रिचुअल अभी भी है?
ये रिचुअल अभी भी है, मगर अभी तक सीजन थोड़ा सा इश्यूज हुए हमें. थैंकफुली एमएसए ने, नेवी ने हमारा बड़ा साथ दिया है.
right.
तो ये जो बैन था पिछले 6-8 महीने से तो वो हटाया है, तो इस सीजन भी ये रिचुअल रहेगा.
yeah.
हमारा ये बहुत एक मजेदार रिचुअल है. right. क्योंकि मिड वीक होता है, हम डे होता है, तो बड़ा मजा आता है वहाँ पे. फिर आप हम ड्राइव करके निकलते हैं, चाय पीते हैं, नाश्ता करते हैं, फिर वापस कहाँ पे?
एंड होम एट
9-10 बजे तक.
नॉट बैड
बेहतरीन का है. उसके अलावा तो हमने आपके साथ चढ़ना पे ही डाइविंग किए हैं. इस साल हम लोग इंशाल्लाह, अगर जो आपने कहा संडे को हम जाएंगे, लाइट हाउस जाएंगे, केबल्स पे जाएंगे, तो है नए साइट से है इस सीजन हम एक्सप्लोर करेंगे.
So, any future plans and certification other than your advance? क्योंकि
इस सीजन
तो कह रहे हैं मास्टर्स को बड़ा बनाएगा वो.
हासिल पहले अपनी शार्क का डर तो खत्म हो गया, मास्टर 40 मीटर तक अभी तक गया.
अच्छा, जस्ट टू अगेन सॉरी अबाउट इट, हमारे पानी में शार्क्स होती हैं, ठीक है?
बिल्कुल.
अब है क्योंकि शार्क इज अ पार्ट ऑफ इको लाइफ साइकिल, राइट? जिस पानी में शार्क नहीं है वहां मछलियां नहीं मिलेंगी.
बिल्कुल.
तो शार्क्स होती हैं तभी हमारे पास बड़ी अच्छी मरीन लाइफ है. तो हसन का डर निकालना पड़ेगा हमें
जी,
शार्क डाइव करानी पड़ेगी.
अभी तक तो ये 40 मीटर भी नहीं गए, वो देखेंगे तो वो देखते हैं इसको क्या होता है. 40 मीटर तक 130 फुट हुआ, 130-140
तकरीबन 120 फीट. तो वेरी नाइस. सो गाइस कहीं मत जाइएगा, हम एक छोटी सी ब्रेक के बाद आते हैं. अगेन जस्ट स्टे ट्यून्ड. ओके गाइस वेलकम बैक, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया जो हमारे साथ ऑनलाइन हैं। एक छोटा सा हम क्विज करते हैं, आई एम गोना आस्क अ सिंपल क्वेश्चन एंड एंड ऑफ द प्रोग्राम, और जो वो जवाब दे देगा डेफिनेटली आप हमें पीएम करिएगा डायरेक्ट पर्सनल मैसेज ऑन द फेसबुक, उसका जवाब बताइएगा और हम आपको एक ज़बरदस्त सा केक फ्रॉम शमाज बेकरी आपको हम डिलीवर करवाएंगे from Indescuba and yes from Shamaa. So Hasan, थोड़ा सा आपकी हम baking skills पे चले जाते हैं, scuba diving छोड़ के baking skills पे चले जाते हैं। So बहुत किस्म के cakes आप लोग बनाते हो?
जी बिल्कुल।
Is there any you know top of the line 3 or 4?
तीन चार किस्म के हैं अगर हम इसको categorize करें into let's say non chocolate and chocolate. नॉन चॉकलेट में दो तीन किस्म के हैं हमारे पास। वी लाइक यूजिंग एवरीथिंग ऑर्गेनिक फ्रेश।
राइट, बाय द वे वी आर हैविंग एन अमेजिंग चॉकलेट माल्ट केक।
यस इंडीड,
जबरदस्त, आप लोग ट्राई करें।
बिल्कुल, एंड वी बिल्ड आवर नेम ऑन क्वालिटी, वैल्यू फॉर मनी एंड द फैक्ट दैट वी डोंट यूज एनी स्टेबलाइजर्स, प्रिजर्वेटिव्स, एनी आर्टिफिशियल इंग्रेडिएंट्स एट ऑल। वी आर वन ऑफ द फ्यू पीपल यूज फ्रेश क्रीम इन द केक्स आल्सो, इट्स कम्स फ्रॉम मुल्तान। So we do fun things, yeah. Fresh, we utilize fresh fruits, strawberries, mangoes, XYZ. Make fresh cream cakes with them. Bunch of ice cream desserts, coffee cakes, cheesecake, savory items like quiches, and of course the three that we're most notable for are all chocolate. We make three kinds: chocolate mousse cake, which is at certain coffee shops in Karachi and Pakistan.
Can you name all them? Those areas, yes, where you. We can have it.
So we work with quite a few restaurants. A huge variety of items are at cafes such as Espresso, who is one of our oldest clients, most favorite clients also. They're very good friends. And
so anyhow, yes, renowned coffee shops.
Yes, renowned coffee shops. Aside from this chocolate mousse cake that you can probably have there, there's the signature chocolate cake, which you can find in many restaurants across
Karachi. Pani aa raha hai muh mein hum sab ke? Yes.
And the last one is what we're eating, which is the chocolate mold cake.
Wow. So, apart from these renowned outlets, हम डायरेक्ट ऑर्डर कहाँ से कर सकते हैं?
बिल्कुल, यू कैन गेट इन टच विद अस वाया फेसबुक और इंस्टाग्राम ऑन बोथ, व्हिच इज शमाज बेकरी ऑन फॉर बोथ ऑफ देम, एंड दैट्स प्रोबब्ली द इजीएस्ट वे बिकॉज़ आवर मेन्यूज़ ऑनलाइन, देयर्स आवर पिक्चर्स एंड सो ऑन. So I think that's probably the easiest way to.
So do you do home deliveries within Karachi?
So it's something that we are working towards. The reason we've been slow with it is because, like I said, we don't use any stabilizers, so it's difficult to transport.
Temperature sensitive. To a specific address and you can then deliver it.
Yes.
Perfect.
Phase 5 DHA.
Yes, phase 5. So I think the address, the end details are on the Facebook, right?
Should be, yes, on our Facebook page.
And you are on Instagram too.
Yes. Shamal Bakery.
So, Aram,
जी
कैसा लगा केक आपको?
मुझे तो हमेशा से अच्छा लगा. मेरे तो
20 साल से खा
रहे. मैं तो वर्कआउट शुरू इसलिए किया था ताकि मैं ये केक जितने मैं रोज के खाता हूँ बर्न ऑफ कर सकूँ.
वेरी नाइस. सो आप घर से फिटनेस फ्रीक हो?
फ्रीक नहीं, एंथुसिएस्ट हूँ. एंथुसिएस्ट हूँ फॉर श्योर. बचपन से आदत थी कि स्पोर्ट्स में थी, फुटबॉल खेला है, क्रिकेट खेला है, बास्केटबॉल खेला है, तो हमेशा से फिटनेस में वो आदत थी, रोज उठ के कुछ करना, एक्सरसाइज करना, कोई एक्टिविटी करना. तो जब मैं अमेरिका मूव हुआ था, मैं काफी छोटा था कंपेयर टू बाकी गोरों से, तो उसके बाद मैंने फिर कहा मुझे जिम भी शुरू करना चाहिए, तो मजा भी आने लग गया. फिर आप देखते हो, आप अपनी बॉडी को प्रोग्रेस करते हुए देखते हो, तो यू एंजॉय इट. फिर आप चीजें लर्न करते हो, बिकम्स ऑलमोस्ट लाइक स्किल सेट. फिर आप अपनी यू नो रिसर्च भी होता है, सो इट्स वेरी एंजॉयबल फॉर मी. इट्स नॉट जस्ट कि मुझे रोज जिम जाना है, मैं इसको स्टडी भी करता हूँ, रिसर्च भी करता हूँ, अंडरस्टैंड करने की कोशिश करता हूँ. तो इट्स अ फुल एनकंपसिंग थिंग फॉर मी. इट्स एन एवरीडे थिंग, इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ माय लाइफस्टाइल. इट्स नॉट कि जिम जाना, इट्स जस्ट हुआ है.
परफेक्ट. सो अगेन बैक टू हसन
जी,
कोई स्पेसिफिक जैसे आप डिस्कस करते अभी ब्रेक के अंदर कि आप कोई reef cleaning या preservation?
बिल्कुल, I think this is a very interesting discussion के which we have often here. It's nice के we can now share this with hopefully a lot more people.
Yes.
Which is basically के the world is because of global warming. Even a degree or two change in our seas and oceans.
Even right now, you know, the winters started in November.
Yeah.
Usually, September में start हो जाते हैं.
बिल्कुल, and it'll stretch later also. Yes. So everything is going later, and I'm sure there are many ramifications for the global warming, which we can assume a fair few of them are negative. One of which is, you know, what's happening, for example, at the Great Barrier Reef, you know, it's getting bleached by a very, what we would imagine, very small couple of degree change in ocean temperatures, sea temperatures. So not to combat this necessarily, but as a mitigating factor or to move it forward, some countries have moved towards, you know, building artificial reefs. And this is something that caught my interest a little while ago. And I started running a feasibility unit to see if it's expensive. And like with everything, if you want to do something large scale, it is expensive.
Right.
That said, that's not going to discourage us. And that's something that I think we're interested in doing at a small scale to begin with, to pilot it. With the help, of course, of you guys, Indiscuba, and you know, the very many members that they have. So I think this is something that's interesting. It's the materials required for it ideally should be organic, so we'll probably be going with some organic materials such as cement and so on. We're still working on which ones we should use. And yeah, to just sort of pilot a small, build an actual small reef with various organic natural items and in various shapes. And just to see what happens with it. And I think it'll work. I think we're interested in getting universities on board so that they can actually conduct tests and see if that's having a positive impact on the ecosystem. And if it is, then we can pitch this to various clients or even hopefully the government and various authorities to make this big scale like they are doing in other countries such as Bahrain.
Yeah. You know, 747.
It's actually quite a technical task. A lot of people have done cars. We were in love with the idea of throwing one of our, you know, Pakistani buses inside. We thought it'd be super cool. But it's quite technical. The paint has to be stripped and has to ensure that with our best of interest at heart, we don't actually end up causing a negative impact. So we'll move with it slowly, but hopefully soon.
Again, what I've learned for the last so many years, कि जब हम कोई रीफ को क्रिएट करते हैं तो वहाँ ब्रीडिंग ग्राउंड बन जाता है मछली का. इवेंचुअली इट कीप्स ऑन मल्टीप्लाइंग और ये हमारी लोकल कम्युनिटी को हेल्प करेगा. उनको बाहर जाने की जरूरत नहीं है. इवेंचुअली वो मछलियाँ बड़ी होंगी, देन दे कैन.
बिल्कुल, इट्स बेसिकली व्हाट यू आर सेइंग इज 100% करेक्ट कि स्टेक होल्डर्स की बात है.
मैं बस कह रहा था वही पूरा इकोसिस्टम क्रिएट होता है ना, जब वो आपके मेटल स्ट्रक्चर पे वो आता है, ब्लॉसम करता है, छोटी फिशेस आती हैं, फिर छोटी फिशेस के पीछे बड़ी फिशेस आती हैं,
शार्क्स आती हैं,
शार्क्स आती हैं,
शार्क्स आती हैं,
तो इट्स जस्ट लाइक एनीथिंग एल्स। जैसे आप पौधे बनाओगे, फॉरेस्ट क्रिएट करोगे, तो जानवर आएंगे, जानवर आएंगे तो इंसान आएंगे, तो पूरा साइकिल चलता है और उसी तरह होता है। आई थिंक इट्स वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स वी नीड टू लुक एट एज ए from an industry standpoint, especially the tourism industry, Prime Minister Imran Khan ne bhi kafi dafa bola hai ki unko tourism ko boost karna hai, ko tourism foreigners lane hai, foreigners ko lane ka ye ek bahut bada tarika hai. Ab Egypt ko dekho, it's the diving capital of the world. Turkey ne aapne ka Bahrain mein plane Dubai hai, Turkey mein Dubai hai, Bahamas mein to pura ek strip hai jahan pe purane boats, gaadiyan wagaira ne Dubai hai aur log jaate hain wahan pe diving shops
ke liye. It helps the economy to boost drastically.
Foreign dollars isi tarah to aayenge, agar koi foreigner aa raha hai usko to pata hi nahi abhi tak ki chadhna hai, diving hai, ye hai. आपने करना क्या है? कुछ करना नहीं है, बहुत जंकयार्ड में हमारे पास कितना मेटल पड़ा
है, कितनी बहुत जगह कराची में
आओ गिराओ, बात नहीं कर रहे हो तो आने का बहुत बड़ा है, आप 5-6 गिराओ, आप उसको 3 साल ब्रीड होने दो, आप देखो चढ़ना वाले पे पूरा मरीन इको सिस्टम बनेगा और लोग आएंगे, बच्चे आएंगे, स्टडी कर सकते हैं क्राच।
सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम चढ़ना आइलैंड, बिकॉज दैट्स इन डिफरेंट प्रोविंस, लेट्स फोकस ऑन सिंध बाय द वे। हम सिंध में भी ये आर्टिफिशियल रीफ बना सकते हैं।
सिर्फ सिंध को छोड़ दें, आप कराची का कोस्ट लाइन देख लें कितना बड़ा है, 200 कितने किलोमीटर का,
अच्छा खासा है,
100-250 से तो ऊपर 100-200 के अंदर ही होगा। 1 किलोमीटर का एरिया ले लो जहाँ पे मतलब रीफ बन सकती है, आप वहाँ पे ट्राई करो, अटेम्प्ट तो करो, देयर इज नो नेट नेगेटिव लॉस प्रूवन हुआ है ये लॉन्ग टर्म में, अगर आप सही से चीज को
जंग, हमने जंग की तो डालने हैं उसमें स्टील स्ट्रक्चर्स जो बड़े बड़े,
खर्चा क्या है, पुरानी चीज पड़ी हुई है उसको बस लेके जाना, एक गो बोट लेनी है, गिरानी है, खत्म होगी बात। आई थिंक इसमें पॉजिटिव्स बहुत है, नेगेटिव्स नहीं है, मगर मसला ये है यहाँ पे पाकिस्तान में जनरली जो इशू आ जाता है, पीपल आर स्लो एक्टिंग, रिएक्टिव है, नो वन वांट्स टू बी प्रोएक्टिव, तो इस गवर्नमेंट को, पीटीआई को, अगर
basically I'll talk about Sindh, you know, last week the Ministry of Sports and Tourism of Sindh province has, you know, did a marvelous job. They have they will be, you know, passing a bill sooner or later, I think within this within 30 days or so, let's see, and they are way too active in, you know, making a committee or a regulatory body for coastal tourism and water sports. तो उससे ये होगा कि हम इंटरनेशनल मार्केट को टैप कर सकते हैं, बिकॉज हमारा इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर अवेलेबल हो जाएगा, नाउ सिंध गवर्नमेंट विल बी विद अस राइट टू प्रमोट द सेम एक्टिविटी, तो जो रीव्स वाला है हम उनके साथ मिलकर,
आई थिंक दिस इज अ फैंटास्टिक फर्स्ट स्टेप, बट इट्स अ फर्स्ट स्टेप, आगे हम मेक श्योर करना है कि दूसरा कदम भी लिया जाए, तीसरा कदम भी लिया जाए, कि ये नहीं किया कि कमेटी बना ली, काम नहीं किया, राइट। हम होप कर रहे हैं कि यहाँ पे, क्योंकि हमने जितनी मीटिंग्स की है चीफ सेक्रेटरी के साथ, स्पोर्ट्स कमेटी के साथ, वो बड़े इंटरेस्टेड भी थे, क्योंकि है ये एक इंटरेस्टिंग चीज,
आई थिंक यू वर देयर इन द मीटिंग विद द चीफ सेक्रेटरी,
वो बड़े इंटरेस्टेड थे, उन्होंने बड़ा सपोर्ट दिया, हमें बताया कि वो भी दिए सहारा दिया कि नहीं आप लोग टेंशन नहीं लो, आपकी डाइविंग होगी इस विंटर, तो हम लोग तो बड़ा खुश निकले थे, अब इंशाल्लाह ये लोग आगे बढ़ाएंगे इसको और कुछ अच्छा ही निकलेगा, कोई अच्छा नतीजा होगा,
राइट। सो हसन,
जो आपने बात की थी, एक तो यही थी कि सब स्टेक होल्डर्स को लेना जरूरी है, पॉलिटिकल एग्जाम्पल कैन बी, अभी रिसेंटली पीपल आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, यू नो, द टाइफॉइड वैक्सीन, के यू नो टाइफॉइड स्प्रेड, पीपल नीड टू बी केयरफुल,
राइट,
एंड द गवर्नमेंट इज वर्किंग टुवर्ड्स, स्पेशली प्रोविंशियल गवर्नमेंट इज वर्किंग टुवर्ड्स एरेडिकेटेड, और नॉट एरेडिकेटेड बट सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रोवाइड relief to the people affected, but they haven't taken many stakeholders on board. You know, there's a lot of NGOs already doing similar work, and if they just coordinated and did it together, it'd be much more effective. So I think that's true, okay, all stakeholders must be involved, including the coastal communities, which we are not necessarily, there are people living there, and if they buy into the idea and the concept, they are really the ones who will take this and take it forward.
Right.
So I think the first step is to actually get everyone on board. And when everyone is on board, then everyone can sort of have their own responsibility, because we dive once, twice, maybe maximum 3 times a week. Mm-hmm. No, these guys live there 7 days a week, and their generations have. So if they are not interested in doing this, then we need to help find a way to make this go further.
Synergy.
The second thing you mentioned, which I think is an interesting point, is, you know, you said they're developing a regulatory body.
Yes.
And I think that's a very important word, and one that I think should be explored by a lot of people. You know, there are stories you can read online. Aram and I have heard a couple of them firsthand, by people going diving and doing other various sporting activities with people who aren't licensed, which usually means they're not skilled in that field. And so this is something I would always warn people generally, is water sports are adventure sports. With all adventure, there's...
I have to stop you right now. Guys, we have to take a small break. We'll be back after just a few minutes.
Let the explorer in you revel in an adventure of a lifetime and discover scuba diving with Indus Scuba, Pakistan's only paddy 5-star dive center, where you can dive into the beautiful waters and conquer your fears. Dive into life and enjoy the ride. So what are you waiting for? Go on a fun dive with Indus Scuba. For further details, visit Indus Scuba. Let the explorer in you revel in an adventure of a lifetime and discover scuba diving with Indus Scuba, Pakistan's only paddy 5-star dive center, where you can dive into the beautiful waters and conquer your fears. Dive into life and enjoy the ride. So what are you waiting for? Go on a fun dive with Indus Scuba. For further details, visit Indus Scuba. Let the explorer in you revel in an adventure of a lifetime and discover scuba diving with Indus Scuba, Pakistan's only paddy 5-star dive center, where you can dive into the beautiful waters and conquer your fears. Dive into life and enjoy the ride. So what are you waiting for? Go on a fun dive with Indus Scuba. For further details, visit Indus Scuba. Let the explorer in you revel in an adventure of a lifetime and discover scuba diving with Indus Scuba, Pakistan's only paddy 5-star dive center, where you can dive into the beautiful waters and conquer your fears. Dive into life and enjoy the ride. So what are you waiting for? Go on a fun dive with Indus Scuba. For further details, visit Indus Scuba. Let the explorer in you revel in an adventure of a lifetime and discover scuba diving with Indus Scuba, Pakistan's only paddy 5-star dive center, where you can dive into the beautiful waters and conquer your fears. Dive into life and enjoy the ride. So what are you waiting for? Go on a fun dive with Indus Scuba. For further details, visit Indus Scuba.
Okay guys, we are back. Aakhri sawal hamare guest se, it's about time. We already spent 44 amazing minutes with amazing drivers. So Hassan, let's start with you. Hum khatam karenge aram pe. Any advice, even you can both talk to each other and let us know. Any advice for newbies who want to, come into recreational scuba diving, not professionally, just as a hobby or something like this?
Yes, do it. And aside from that, if you want to do it, do it responsibly. Yeah. I think that's probably the first thing I want to share. Second thing is perhaps scuba diving, because it's generally, for many years, it's been something that's not had, not everyone's had a lot of access to. So it seems something that's really out of reach or something that's too distant or something that's far from us. It's actually much simpler than that. You just need to get yourself to a dive center such as this one. Mm. And come there, get a little bit of information. If you're uncertain, do a discovery scuba dive. Mm. And you will find out in the first 10 minutes whether you love it or not. Yeah. Most do. And you do next steps to get licensed. And like I said, do it responsibly. There's a lot of this activity is also slightly unregulated, where there are certain dive companies that are taking people diving and are not necessarily licensed to do so. So make sure you do your homework and dive with companies like Indus that are certified, with make sure instructors certified. All this information is online. You can run their dive license number on the PADI website and find out if they're actually certified, because like with any adventure sport, there is certain risks associated with it, and you just want to make sure you're being careful. And there's lots of fun, and Karachi's got a huge coastline, so enjoy it.
Yeah. So Arun, what's your
I think the first thing I would say कि मुस्तफा भाई से आके मिल लो अगर डाइविंग करनी है मैं भी वेरी सीरियस कि पहले आओ डाइव सेंटर आओ बात कर लो 15 मिनट यहाँ पे जो भी बैठा होता है they're very friendly they're very informative वो आपको सब बता देंगे आपको अगर इनिशियली सिर्फ पूल डाइव करनी है पूल डाइव भी आके करें get a feel for it and see if you like it or not because I mean at this point कराची में ये चीजें बढ़ रही है राइट एंड यू वांट टू गेट इन्वॉल्व विद इट इट इज सच अ नाइस कम्युनिटी हमारे जो इतने भी हम लोगों के साथ मिलते हैं दे बिकम इंस्टेंटली बिकम फ्रेंड्स दोस्त बन जाते हैं मतलब वी कीप इन टच एंड दिस एंड दैट लाइक बड़ी अच्छी कम्युनिटी है तो नॉट ओनली डू यू गेट लाइक द एडवेंचर पार्ट ऑफ इट लाइक इन द स्कूबा डाइविंग एट द बीच एंड स्टफ यू आल्सो गेट अ गुड टाइट नेट कम्युनिटी ऑफ पीपल हु आर देयर फॉर ईच अदर हु हेल्प ईच अदर एंड इसमें तो सबसे पहले तो जैसे जब ये इशू हुआ था बैन का लाइक द वे द होल कम्युनिटी रैली बिहाइंड मुस्तफा भाई एंड द स्कूबा एंड द अदर डाइवर्स एंड द डाइव सेंटर्स इन कराची टू यू नो फाइट दिस इशू क्योंकि अगर नहीं करते तो यही होता कि बैठे रहते घर पे कोई बैन हटता ही नहीं तो आई थिंक इट्स अ वेरी फन थिंग टू डू आई थिंक इट्स सच अ ग्रेट एक्टिविटी इट्स अ वीकेंड एक्टिविटी इट्स अ विंटर एक्टिविटी सो इट्स नॉट लाइक इट्स टाइम कंज्यूमिंग हफ्ते में एक दिन जाओ एंजॉय करो इट्स पीसफुल यू देयर with your own thoughts you can't hear anything else it's just silence and you and the water
yeah so by the way Arham you know just mentioned those who wants to you know start scuba diving they can always you know do a discovery program by the way you don't have to buy anything even every equipment is on rental basis so whatever the price is everything is included just bring your towel and yourself in to our dive center right am I right
yeah, that easily yeah.
you don't have to buy anything
kahi jana bhi nahi hai agar bahut dar lag raha hai aa jao pool mein kar lenge 5 10 minute agar acha laga to fir samundar mein le jayenge
exactly and right actually it's a really I think diving I think anywhere in the world the because it's inherently a sport that's pursued by a smaller amount of percentage of the population that the community is really close in it so you become like super friendly with everyone and while diving is a serious act an activity to take seriously it's a very relaxed atmosphere and it's a lot of fun you know you get a day out you're on a boat you get to meet people chat eat some shama cake often
puri masti hai
yes definitely acha by the way whenever we have Hasan and Aram on board hamare paas cakes hote hain to jab bhi aap dekhein Hasan ko hamari boat pe to definitely aapko cake mil jayega available hota hai by the way the cakes are amazing yes Let me ask a very last question. I told you guys, three kisam ke top of the line cakes Hasan screen hame bataye the. If you guys can able to answer step by step, what are the three cakes? Shama Bakery gonna send you over. I mean the whole big cake.
First person to answer.
आप लोग आंसर को शेयर मत करिएगा. आप हमें डायरेक्ट इनबॉक्स करें अपना आंसर. ठीक है. I think Monday cut off date rakhte hain iski
Monday
right yeah. so you have tomorrow and day after 48 hours to think about it three top line cakes so you know thank you very much Hasan
thank you for having us
thank you yep for coming in you know cake was amazing
I'm glad you liked
yes
it. The cakes
Yes, the cakes. By the way, the cakes. All of them are amazing. By the way, हम सब ने सारे केक्स नहीं खाए हमने we had small pieces of cakes. वरना हम diving नहीं कर सकते first two thing. So guys, thank you very much for signing in. Inshallah next week Friday को हम दोबारा मिलेंगे hopefully with either one or two guests. Thank you very much for tuning in, signing in. And you know, keeping all, you know, sending all the feedbacks to us. आपसे इजाजत मांगूंगा. Again, Arham and Hasan, thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you.
Guys, thank you. Khuda hafiz and Pakistan, zindabad.